mikrofonen igen. Och så lägger vi fönstren i rätt ordning. Så ser vi vad som händer.
Doing a great job beautifying our great nation's youth, champ. How in your head? I feel, you know, live and more wheels. Think at the top of my game, you can. Ugh. Hold your breath for another couple of minutes or a famous free can. I should intervene, but I can't be asked.
Här har vi då Hector, episode 3. Jag har väl kommit ungefär halvvägs in. Det är ett humoristiskt peka och klicka äventyrsspel. Ha, ska vi se. Jop. Jag kommer inte riktigt på vad man ska göra. Vi måste få vår arbetskollega så ful som möjligt så han kan vara med i tävlingen här. För att vi måste komma upp på scenen och varna folk för att det är en terrorist på ingång. Har vi snorungarna?
The only thing standing between me and the safety of this town is one tiny strand of razor wire. What can I say? Well, I ain't Bruce Willis.
Nope.
I can't combine that. All those things together.
Jim Jow's tag tråd. Regurgitator. Just det, det var ju åkattraktionen. Mellow Game. Kan man måla? Nej. Prata med killen här och se om han gör något. Måste vi prova lite själv innan vi kollar tipsen.
So you're all fixed now then?
Well, you know, the light has broken down.
As I noticed.
Det verkar vara en rätt jag vet inte vad man ska säga om den här tivoliga attraktionen.
Who was that aged rocker in the luminous jacket?
Oh, that's Mr. Fix, maintenance man. Very reliable.
Reliable at what?
You know, tjenare Patrik. Tack för bitten och grattis till andra platsen.
Fixing the ride from behind the bush.
Who said anything about fixing the ride, man?
Oh, please don't laugh at inappropriate times. It makes me nervous.
Hur är läget med Patrik?
He didn't look like he was doing much fixing when I saw him.
He was fixing all right. We've got a
general spyware. Fan, det droppar in folk. Hur är läget?
You know, in today's book, you don't need to keep your guy love a secret.
Love? What? No. No! No!
Har du gjort något kul idag, Spyware? Patrik, har du gjort något kul? Någon måste ha gjort något kul idag.
Believe what you want, man. Ain't like that.
Are you wasting away? When's the last time you had a good meal?
I don't have much of an appetite these days. Except for the regular delivery of the good stuff from Mr. Fix.
What good stuff? You mean pastrami?
Jag är sjuk och tragglar mig genom Oldboy. Men Oldboy är bra. Jag såg ju när Hero spelade. Det såg ju fantastiskt ut. Vad tycker du om Oldboy? Garanon vart i garaget hela dagen för att dodge för blästring. Nice. Inspektör CTS. Ja, känner du virus?
Settle down, fella. It's only pastrami after all.
Okay. Den här killen går på droger, den saken är ju klar.
So, can I have some of whatever he gave you?
Back off, man!
Settle down, fella. It's only pastrami.
Det här är nog inte pastrami, ser du?
Okay, okay, I understand.
Hur är läget med virus då? Nej, det tycker jag inte. Det är vackert, bra musik, bra karaktär, men gameplayet är ett sömnpiller. Vad är för fel på gameplayet då?
Another satisfied customer. My lord, he looks titillated, constipated,
tantalized,
sodomized, pacified, horrified. Hector, this ride has it all. You enter a baby caterpillar and emerge. Man, that man looked like he's passing a baby caterpillar. He may very well be.
Okay. Fan, man kan göra något här. Prata med honom.
This is the bit where I'll make a rude or insulting observation, but I've got nothing bad to say about filthy rich.
CTS, vad han gjorde idag? Vi har spelat färdigt Doom 64 har vi gjort. Annars har jag mest bara varit med pojken. Vi var ute och lekte lite på förmiddagen. Tatt det lugnt. Antingen händer det för lite eller för mycket. Okay. Ja, det låter väl som en bra sammanfattning.
No, this is just a stopgap for me. I'm dabbling with a few new business ventures here and there, just waiting for the funds to come through. I can tell you more, but I don't want to ruin the surprise. I can't wait. What are you in the mood for? Oh, something sweet, moist, and smells faintly of cherry. Are we talking about the same thing? Depends. What were you talking about? You first. Not you. I was talking about food. Then I also was talking about the food.
Ska man ge honom mat? Har ingen mat. Kan man måla honom med guldfärg, tror jag? Nope. Fick du ingen notifikation? Det var konstigt. Det borde du ha fått.
Hey, if it stops doing it for real, I'm all for it. Same way I feel about violent video games, virtual pornography and tofurkey.
Tofurkey, alltså. Det är skapligt soligt ute. Jag har fått en del gjort här hemma, så det är ju bra. Här är det molnigt och luktar regn. Ja. Där kan man tydligen inte göra så mycket med just nu. Kan man måla dem guld?
Jag
har inte sett det här spelet förr. Det heter Hector, Badge of Carnage. Finns på Steam. 3 episoder.
Interesting color.
Oh, that isn't icing. That's spit up. Little Keeper must have been at that one. He just loves icing, he does. He wants it morning, noon, and night.
I know the feeling.
Ska vi se om jag kan komma någon vart. Det är ju så här klassiskt. Det är ju inte alltid det är logiskt vad man ska göra. Det är regn i luften och hunden hittar en lerpöl. Jag älskar när det är regn i luften, liksom. Inte när det regnar sådär, men när det luktar regn och är så här tung luft eller vad man ska säga, det tycker jag är skitskönt.
I'm no expert on children, but I believe his nappy needs changing.
Really? Because on the package it said they're good for 10 to 12 pounds.
Oh Christ, I can feel my IQ dropping just standing close to you.
Okej. Okay.
So, cakes for loved ones on the inside.
A special cake from a loved one is just what a convict needs to take his mind and, if applied correctly, sometimes his whole body out of the constant hardships inside.
Hardships? In prison? 3 square meals, a roof, a mattress, TV and a flushing toilet? They live better than I do. Group sure aside, of course.
Okej, det verkar inte som att man kan göra något där heller.
You?
Vi fortsätter framåt. Alltså, det var toaletten. Det kan man göra mer här, tror jag. Vi stal toalettringen, gjorde vi. Tänk när vi flyttar så här, hoppas på åska och blixt. Då höjer vi spelljudet. Doom förut hade ju skithögt ljud, så att det...
I don't need to go, and even if I did, I wouldn't go in there.
Hon kanske är med ballerinakjol. Helium tanks, kan man måla dem i guld?
Well, those things to... Fear kind of ends with a plop, doesn't it?
Kanske man ska göra något med öltältet. Då blir det för högt. Då tar vi ner den lite så då. Hur är vi, känns det bättre nu då?
Surprise, surprise. The one with a gun is the most popular booth at the fair. Men and women. Now you're just being stupid.
Yep, probably. Tunnel of sweet love. Can we do that with baby?
Who's your daddy?
Can we talk about something else?
Lite bättre balans, okej. Okay. Guldfärgad tårta, kanske.
What are you?
Du kanske vill ha guldfärg och lägga på tårtorna?
Nej. Those things.
Det låter bra, bra. Nu ska vi sen bara se om jag kan räkna ut vad fan man ska göra. Kan man åka i tunneln?
Never.
Nej, det vill han inte. Det är de där pärlorna.
Hey guys, what's in there?
Kan vi prata med blinda Ali, kanske?
Oj, it's blind alley.
Ja, men alltså ingen vettigt. Kanske, det känns som att man ska göra något med åkattraktionen också. De som sitter där på mår inte så bra just nu, skulle jag vilja våga påstå här. Ah, det där är ju inget nytt.
Rock on.
Enormous underpants.
Stretchy.
Stretchy. Pretty fatty.
Well, those things to... I'd be safer throwing myself out of a tree.
Antagligen. Jag skulle inte åka den där om jag var... Och då åker jag ändå gärna lite allt möjligt när jag är på... Och så de här jävla snurringarna igen.
Yeah, that's right, y'all. Peace, boy.
And there'll be plenty more of that if you're lucky. But first, my latest release.
DJ är så rolig, alltså. Regurgitering, ja, det passar den där med tanke på hur fort den snurrar.
This next one's called Talking.
Ja, nu är vi tillbaka här igen. Nytt att säga här, kanske.
Good day, handsome. Would you like to make a donation nej. To the Clappers?
Jag har redan donerat $25,000. Det räcker. Kanske det man ska göra.
I'd love to, madam.
Would you like to donate coins, a check or a debit card?
Check.
A check?
Oh, lovely. Here's an envelope.
Nice, no,
make
kuvert.
A check out to the Preservation Society and drop it back here anytime, dearie.
Nu frågar jag vad jag ska göra med ett kuvert. Jaha, okej.
Okay. I can see my golden glowing face in this envelope. Sadly, I can't see anything else in it. It's empty.
Nej, nu har vi ett guldfärgat brev. Okej. Okay. Oh, was...
Good day, handsome.
I already did my check.
I already did, mate.
Have you returned it? I don't see your check in the pile.
How do you know?
Because there are no checks in the pile.
Well, I need a pen.
Ooh, that reminds me. Shorty Polchester's doing an autograph signing later. Have to look my best.
Shorty.
Well, you hoping for a bit of backstage funny business?
Never know when Shorty's around.
Ah, yeah, han var ju... Han hängde ju på bordellen, den killen. Kan man inte göra så här? Nej.
Nah, you're just...
Vill du ha ett... Nej.
What are you? And... Seldom has so much been so wrecked by one old alky.
Sant. In öltältet igen kanske?
I keep thinking it's gonna be better in this time, but it never is. Oh, maybe they'll do a lager fountain later. That always classes up a party.
Jag tror inte man kan göra så mycket här inne. De är däckade hela bunten.
Not while I'm on duty. Ah, what the hell. This whole situation's so blimmin' twisted, I'll probably solve it better with a fuzzy head.
Little gang.
Do I look like I drink light beer?
Nej, det gör du faktiskt inte.
Alpha 1-9-er, initiate protocol Numa Numa.
Min näsa kliar med. Bannade pollen. Look a tiny human.
What are you meant to be? A turd?
Snäll Anna. Just det, där har vi skurken. Du har ett... Nej.
Oh, come on. All those things together?
Nej, jag får nog ta ett tips här, för jag fattar ingenting. Som vanligt. Guldkuvert. Nej, titta, nu kom det ju något nytt här.
I'm Bellamy Brown.
Du var inte där
innan. A thin slice of hope to your otherwise vacant lives. Hey, stranger, you've been looking for a great contest? Feeling lucky? Care to take a stab?
My luck's all out right now. I'm thinking really hard about the stab, though.
Gå dit, pratar vi med honom då.
Sir, I'm gonna have to ask you to move your illegally parked skip.
A joker. I can see that, mate. I can see that. Illegally parked skip. You're talking about a classic British automobile. They don't make them like this anymore, I tell you. Almost sad to part with.
Then don't.
How many miles on the clock? It's kind of hard to see the dash.
Don't fret. This vehicle is in guaranteed tip-top condition right out of the showroom this morning.
How do you explain the 5-year rust build-up on the rear wing, then?
Rust? Oh. Oh, that. That's just, bean sauce.
Does it come with a full service history and extended warranty?
Does it come with a full service history and extended warranty?
No, but it comes with a full measure of step into my car, honey. You're coming home with me.
Okay.
What about breakdown cover?
This thing is made in England. You won't be needing that.
Okay.
Your voice hurts my ears.
Not half as much as it'll hurt to lose the opportunity to win this car.
I almost say, alright.
Or segue. You could work for Clap FM.
I do. Drive time.
Can I take it for a test spin?
Can I take it for a test spin? Only if you
win, which is very doubtful.
Floyd?
Alright. It's apparent you won't shut up until I ask. What's the contest?
Oh. I'm so glad you asked. This exceptional British-made, British classic is filled to the brim with a British breakfast standard. All you need to do is tell me this. How many baked beans did we cram into this 1965 vintage
bilen med bönor? Oh my god.
Hang on. You mean this rust bucket is full of baked beans?
Yep, chockers to the absolute hilt. The question is, how many?
If it were how many beans I could cram it to be gob, I could get behind a contest like that.
What do I win? By the beanie, of course.
But who the hell would want to win a car full of baked beans?
Who wouldn't, you mean?
Fan, det måste ta tid att städa den, om den är helt full med bönor.
So what does it cost to enter this scam?
It's absolutely free of charge.
Now you're speaking my language.
Would you care to hazard a guess? Come on, it's not like I'm asking you to donate a lung.
Normally, I don't get suckered into gimmicks like this, but all your swanky talk has me convinced my losing streak is over.
Okay, I'll make a guess.
Okay, I'll make a guess.
Fire away.
Vad är det här nu då? 832 040 69 105 8 675 309, eller 6,022 gånger 10 to the 23rd. Alltså det går ju för i pass hur jävla många bönor som helst i en bil. Det är ju en av de två skulle jag tippa på. Ingen aning vad 6,022 gånger 10 to the 23rd ens betyder, men vi chansar på 8 miljoner.
8675309.
And how do you spell 99?
With an E in the middle.
Best one today by far. Take a glance over there at what you could have won.
Could have won? Jag har alltså inte vunnit.
Hey, looking only.
What, I can't look with me hands?
Vill du ha ett kuvert?
I can't hand him an empty envelope.
Nej.
So, how long did it take you to count them all?
Well, me? I didn't count them. I have a light.
Fan, har räknat dem nu?
Besides, I wasn't trusted with that information. Not after I accidentally raffled St. Martha's Church at their recent fundraiser.
What, the old church?
Yep, the parishioners were mighty peeved when they turned it into a gentleman's club.
Oh, det var där vi var.
Well, if it's any consolation, they got their divine retribution in the end.
Brann upp.
So where's the answer then?
All I know is, somewhere out there there's a gold envelope. That golden envelope has a number inside. And when that envelope crosses my palm, I shall open it and publicly declare in my unrivaled dynamic style the number of beans.
Okay.
When's that golden envelope guy supposed to show up?
I don't know, but soon, I hope. I prefer to shift this beast before the sun gets too high, if you get me.
Do I stand much chance of winning this beanmobile?
All who enter have a fighting chance. But no, not likely.
Okay, so I must also hit the...
I want to make another guess.
Shoot.
6.022 times 10 to the 23rd.
Yes, something tells me this contest has a mole.
So, what are the odds of me winning based on that guess?
You have the same chance I have of meeting Elvis while riding a blue-winged tiger past Venus.
Null. Huh?
Now you just... Oh, please, let there be a discarded chicken and mushroom follow-up in there. Good question. Why don't I just leave now and never come back? I could move somewhere nicer with less crime, like Leicester.
Okej, så vi måste hitta några siffror och lägga i brevet. Och så måste vi ha penna.
Not even Fadum Savior now. Kunstenje, patajiti fola, kinja toto.
Aj, jag vet fan. Penna, vem har en penna?
Yeesh, talking to you is about as useful as a flymo in a fish tank.
Som du har något vettigt att säga.
Now goes the public relations.
Oh great, I've got 12 new followers on Twitter in the past hour.
Well, too bad, they'll all be dead soon.
Not all of them, one was from out of town.
It's been a long day, why don't you take the afternoon off?
Oh well, boss. Thanks. Oh, wait. If I leave, who'll be in charge of the colouring in pages? I'd better stick around.
That's some skewed dedication to duty you've got. Have I told you lately that you're like a useless appendage to me?
Not recently, no.
You're like a sixth toe or a third nipple.
You mean normal people don't have three? Oh, now I feel even worse.
Okay. I don't know how much guitar I can show.
Shall we talk strategy about your upcoming gurning tournament?
Let's do this!
Good news. I know how to fix your face.
Oh, that is good news.
There's a ride I need you to go on. It'll do wonders for your chances in the competition. Only the fat bastard who runs it probably won't let you on without a ticket. Plus, the need for currency at this funfair seems to be arbitrary.
Did you say fat?
Yep.
Well, if I know fat people, and I do, currency's not the only thing he values.
Shallow, yet insightful.
Huh.
Forget it.
Oh, good idea.
Don't let him...
Thanks,
Bob. Han måste åka I kärlekstunneln. Bara frågan vad man ska... Vi behöver mat alltså. Hur köper man en tårta om man inte har pengar? Är väl frågan. Kan jag ta ett brev till kanske?
I already got an envelope.
Okay, fine.
One was called Yo-ho, that baby ain't mine. We're gonna take a little break, but we'll be back in a while. So, don't nobody go nowhere. Alright, boys, did a blues riff in B. Watch me for the changes and try to keep up.
So we can. Prata oss till någon information här kanske.
Nah, can't be asked.
Kanske man göra så.
Hey, Rich, mind if my partner takes a spin?
Partner? Hey, Hector, I didn't know you swung that way.
No, we're not partners.
Oh well, in that case, he pays. This barely does not feed itself.
What about those guys? They've been on there all day.
They're shareholders. I tell you what, you do something nice for me,
hey, nice.
I give you a free pass for your friend.
Tack för hosten, Nilsson.
Okay.
Vad ska jag göra då?
What are you in the mood for? Or something
sweet,
moist, and smells faintly of cherry.
Are we talking about the same thing?
Bagaren igen då?
You for... Yeah, then I...
Hur är läget med Nilsson då? Du har en sån?
Nej, okay.
Den där kanske. Ah.
Phew, got a lot.
Only one really. Pop that one up there when I saw you coming. Open for an easy sale, low-hanging fruit, as they say.
My reputation precedes me.
I can see it coming round the corner.
Some day down, how will you have? Har vi gjort framsteg I så fall? Det ju alltid skönt. Skallebank, aj, aj, aj. Jodå, jag mår bra.
Ah, Hector, you never stop giving. You're a true sight.
Jag inte klaga. Avslutade Doom 64 I en tidigare stream.
A free pass.
Och
to my tunnel.
Nu ska jag avsluta det här spelet.
Yes, give it to a friend. And now I shall enjoy this delectable cake.
Jaha. Kan han åka nu då? Så blir han...
What was that? Never mind that. What was that? Dios mio, where did you get all this cake?
The free sample tray at the jailbait stall. Not again. Fifth time today.
Kan du åka tunneln nu? Nice.
So I'd like the lamp here to experience all your ride has to offer.
Det här kan ju inte sluta bra för honom alltså.
I give him the works.
Thanks, boss. I like the gentle rides at fairgrounds.
Before you go on, I must ask, any allergies or skin irritations?
I require regular applications of hand sanitizer.
Any sensitivities we should know about?
My gums get tender after I floss.
Are you pregnant?
Pregnant? Why?
Because you may be by the time it's over.
Jag vill inte åka den här attraktionen.
Right, on you go.
Is this anything like the teacups?
No, Lambert, it's nothing like the teacups.
Oh, good, because I threw up after the teacups.
Second star to the right. And straight on to L.
Okay.
And that, Lambert, is where babies come from, would you think?
Oh my god.
Perfect. Quasimodo will feel like Brad Pitt if he can see you, Lambo. Meet me at the info booth. We've got a stage to crash.
Nice. Jag tycker aldrig åka den här attraktionen om jag ser den någonstans i verkliga livet ändå. Haha. Ah, man kan ju använda kartan för att gå direkt kanske. Det var smidigare. Och nu. Den där snorungarna igen.
This is a song for all you lovers out there.
Så, kan vi ställa upp honom i tävlingen?
Good day, madam. I believe everything is in order, yeah? One hideously contorted mutant freak complete with ridiculous horse collar.
Ooh, he's perfect!
Perfect? Ha! Perfectly peas into the eye, maybe. Perfect cheekbones, maybe.
It's been years since we saw any young blood in this competition.
Likely it's been years since you saw anything at all, madam.
I've put him through to the next round. Judging's about to start. Straight through the stage door there.
Tja, I'll eat you like high-priced artisan wedding cake on a lovely lace doily. You're so normal-looking, you probably couldn't even get a job as an extra on Doctor Who.
Now, Bernard, may the best man win. Don't let him get to you. He's really a dear.
I was thinking moose myself.
Skön attityd, ja.
Hey, little beautiful man. Think you can beat me, eh? Your candy-nosed, moisturizing little rose petal of an entry looks like he's bathed in the piss of a thousand angels. Tja, your uniformly huge skin tone makes babies laugh. Prepare now for failure, face. Zip the Mako Panda in, Adonis, or I'll Botox you backstage.
Now, before I turn the mic over to these out-of-work, pug-faced attention cravers, a quick reminder that later yours truly will be cutting the ribbon at the grand reopening of the clock tower, unveiling the town's spanking new ringtone. So, let's kick off strip
wake-up. What was that you just said about the new ringtone?
It's only the grand finale of Clapfest, the Preservation Society's Shined the Old Clock Tower up to its original lackluster, stuck more bells in there, and at 10 o'clock we all get a treat for the ears when we hear the clock's new ringtone, Yowza.
Balls. Oh, that's the trigger for the ball. Anybody know what this new ringtone sounds like?
Yeah, right there. B-I-D-G-E. Pretty lame if you ask me.
I could play it for you.
No, don't play a note. Bring it on. B-I-D-G-E. B-I-D-G-E. Lambert! The badges are the bombs.
Everyone in town is wearing one. They all have their own individual dose of evil juice primed to go off when the clock tower rings.
People of Clappers!
Hi-ha! Greetings, citizens. Can we all give a big welcoming hand to Detective Inspector Hector Town Hero, the very man you all have to thank for the restoration of the clock tower, the cleansing of the Clappers Peak High Street, and providing a generous donation to fund this very festival.
Listen, you're all in serious...
Now, Hector, I've seen you running all over Clapfest. It seems you've worked out the big surprise in store for everyone. Now, don't you go spilling the secret before it's time, or you could end up ruining everything. Understand? See you all at 10 o'clock. Enjoy what's left of your life. I mean, day.
Bags of ball.
Bags of ball. Ha, nu är vi tillbaka i klocktorn igen.
I've got to find a way in there and catch Barnsley before he sets off the bombs. And somehow I don't think it's going to be as easy as picking the lock with a dirty needle this time.
Ingenting.
Any chance it will be unlocked? One chance. Fat. Just as I thought. That's a hell of a lot more securely locked than last time I was here. He soldered the keyhole shut, so the only way to open it is from the inside. Or by bashing the hell out of it with something really, really heavy. Then I'd still...
Men vi vinner den här bilen, tror jag. Behöver vi fortfarande en penna, kanske? Har det hänt något här borta? Nej. Där de är kvar.
Hey, if it stops them doing it for real, I'm all for it. Same way I feel about Vod.
Oh. Intressant. Var vi färdiga här vid tältet då? Eller är vi i scenen? Vi tippar på det här.
You heard what Barnsley said. If I go for the microphone again, it'll set off the badges.
Oh, can I do good evening, mate?
Good day, handsome. Would you like to...
Yep.
I'll be off.
I'll be here.
What those things?
Vem har ett papper man kan stoppa i kuvertet där? Och alkoholisten som målar ansikten. Det går ju så där bra.
So the infamous coach poker finally caught after all this time. Do you know how many people I had to wrongly accuse before we finally arrested you? Answer? A lot. You've poached your last coach, creep. No time for a kip.
Have a little bit of that weapon, I guess.
Oh, great! You brought the weapons cache. Hand it over.
I beg your pardon. These are for the community display. It's a collection of things we don't use in everyday police work. Allegedly. Public eye and all that.
Hey, any idea how I can rig a guessing contest?
Depends. How'd you win?
Well, apparently there's someone around here with a gold envelope containing a number inside.
Who?
That's the thing. Nobody knows.
For all I know, it could be you then.
It isn't me, Lambert.
But it could be.
Yup.
Why aren't you out collecting death badges like I told you?
Oh, I started to do it. Then there was this man and he had a really funny t-shirt. It said something like, if I were a carpenter and you... No, wait. If you were a carpenter and I was... Moan.
no, that's not it either. Oh, it doesn't matter. Anyway, I asked him where he got it, and he thought I was talking about the food he was eating, because he was holding his lump
of... Lambert?
Oh, sorry, I got distracted. What were we talking about?
Hey, I'm thinking about...
What do you mean?
A gold envelope with a number in it.
What, like any old number on a piece of paper?
Yeah.
Oh, that sounds tricky. Maybe it's time to face the ugly truth and accept that you need help. Well, there's got to be someone around here with a pen who can help you out.
Okay, we just got to hit on a pen.
Forget it.
Oh, good idea.
Don't.
Thanks.
DJ:n en penna, kanske. Så han och bölar. Kanske man ska prata med honom då. Bernard Wibley.
Oh, there, Bernard. Can't win them all.
Don't look at me. I'm gorgeous.
Under arrest.
Oh, not bloody Ofcom again. Let me be more specific. You're under arrest on suspicion of terrorism.
Right, and you're under arrest on suspicion of having a 32-inch waist. Imagine completing world tour expert level on your play pops, and all you've got to show for it is a complete lack of actual musical talent. Do you know anything by Foo Fighters?
Hey, do you know anything by Fat Fighters?
Man, you've seen that one coming. The answer was staring me in the face the whole time. What do they call a guy who hangs around with musicians? Oh, you know that one already. I can see my gold. Sadly, I can. Nah, you're just being...
Du har inget nytt att säga. Tycker jag att killen som målar ansikten borde ha en penna, men det har han ju inte.
What's in that cake? Bah, jailbreak. Every cake like a Kinder egg for prisoners. So far today, I've swallowed 2 metal files, a dentist mirror, a set of Dremel bits, and a set of cuff key.
Must be playing havoc with your gastric staples.
You are not kidding. But hey, if they all make it out the other end, it's Chez Le Buffet this Saturday for me, eh?
The new conversation.
So what's so special about those jailbait cakes again? The cakes themselves? Not special at all. In fact, they taste like fiberglass insulation with a maraschino cherry on the top. No, it's what's in the cakes. It's called jailbait. You're a detective. You figure it out.
Men var är han någonstans då?
Ciao. Later.
Vart är han då? Han är i början kanske.
Before you say au revoir, stop and win this
whole shift. Men kanske öltältet? Nej. Han var inte där och inte där. Inte här. Här är dassen. Nej, det är lugnt, Scarecrow. Det är en bra idé faktiskt. Och det är helt okej att komma med tips och sånt. Det har ingenting emot alls. Ja, då är det bara rörskrut var det någonstans. Jag har inte spelat där förut heller, så har du något att säga om det kanske? Nej.
You do realise I could lock you away. Are you a member of...
Heavens, I just... Why...
Don't leave town.
Where would I...
Got a hot nom.
Any suspicious activity?
Good. Boy.
Man, it's taking every ounce of concentration you've got to keep those two words rattling around up there, ain't it?
Ska vi se om vi har något här. Man kan ju få lite tips här. Värsta dåligt kan jag säkert göra med bilen när jag vunnit den. Jopp. Det visste jag redan. Feel the unknown existence of a goal that will open the number inside us. And always talk to everyone at the fair until you find out who has it. Ah, where's the number? Hear that? Someone somewhere is crying ugly tears. Ah. Aha. Så vad var det han stod? Här. Nu är jag borta igen. Där är ettan. Åh. Nice.
Poor old Bernard Bradley. He may not be number one anymore, but he should stand proud knowing he's got a face like a number two.
Oh, så nu vinner vi bilen.
A gold envelope with the number one inside.
Åh, vi gissar på att det är en böna i bilen. Så jävla dumt. Förutsatt att det funkar, vill säga.
Don't just gawk in awe from afar and make a guess.
I should probably tell the guy my guess first. Imagine going through all this rigmarole and then blowing it right at the end. What a complete waste of my time that would have been.
Jag måste väl gissa på ett.
I want to make another guess. Shoot.
One?
That's it. One.
Your guess is one?
Yes. One.
If this contest wasn't free, I'd say you were throwing your money away. Oh well, it's your funeral. Right. One it is.
Brevet.
Just don't picture yourself driving this sweet ride into the sunset.
That's okay. I'm too busy picturing myself driving this sweet ride into a city landmark.
Beans in a beanie. Beans in a beanie.
Hey, mister. While you was over there thinking about ponies, an officious looking prig dressed in a suit just like yours put that on your windscreen.
Eh? Oh, it's the envelope. How did I miss him?
Probably because you're a gullible twat with an ass for a chin.
Gather round, people. It's the moment you've all been loitering around for.
That's it.
The official golden envelope has arrived. This envelope contains the number of beans packed into this here vintage 1965 beanie. Some lucky lad or lassie at the fair will be driving home
in this British classic.
The grand total of beans in this automobile is...
One. One bean? How can that be? I've got more than one bean stuck between my teeth.
What? Well, it came out of a golden envelope, so it must be true. Now, did anyone here say one?
Oh, it's me! I've won the car! This is the happiest moment of my entire day.
Ah, oh, well done, you. What a stroke of good luck.
Most men only dream of winning a beanie. And here I am, living the dream. There's a knack to opening the driver's door. Hold the button in and give the handle a good yank.
Doktorens dörr är öppen.
Weren't there beans in the petrol tank too? Could that even happen?
Yep.
Oh.
Nice.
I'm getting to like the taste of flour. Gets better every time, like caviar or urine. Did I say urine? I meant Valueland cider. Right, where's this tosspot then?
Jag antar att man ska in här på den vänster. Går vi upp så blir det väl inte så bra, ska jag tro.
Locked! You're damn stronger than I thought.
Busted Distillery, de brände hemma i klocktornet förra episoden.
Oh, I ain't touching that with me bare hands. I like me fingers too much. Always meant to come back here with Murder Most Moist 11. Now we'll never know the true joy of moving pictures.
Murder Most Moist. I need to exit.
Leave? I just flew through a windscreen to get in here. I ain't just walking back outside. Barnsley Noble.
Ah, Detective Inspector Hector. I heard the familiar sound of the wanton destruction of municipal property downstairs and knew you must have arrived.
Game's over, bucko. You know what man ska välja?
Was it Shakespeare who said that no noble deed goes unpunished? Oscar Wilde, you imbecile, read a book.
Oh, pardon me for getting my raving literary ponces confused. I could have just gone with games over, bucko, but I was trying to make an effort.
You'll probably never get away with this.
You'll probably never get away with this.
Probably.
I'll try my absolute best to stop you, but I have my doubts that I'll succeed.
Well, it's good to be honest.
Before you destroy us all, I just have one question for you.
I'm all ears.
The chances are that question will lead to more questions.
That's okay. I love a good chit-chat.
What was the point of all those useless quests you had me on?
Surely you've worked it all out by now.
Let's pretend I'm a complete dullard and I haven't yet.
Shouldn't be too hard to imagine. Ask away.
Why'd you make me fix the clock?
I think that was the most obvious.
Try me.
I trust that since you escaped the death tank, you found your way into my lab at the farm, yes? You heard the notes and saw the fate of the poor badger. Now, where best to play those notes for a whole town to succumb to them? Ah, the sound of the pealing bells ringing across the sky will, to me, be the sweet sound of rebirth.
Wow. Where the hell is my 25,000 quid?
Why, how do you think I funded this lovely festival?
Boy, can't get much for 25 large these days.
Most of it went on the band.
Banded?
Why did you make me tear down the Exotico? May it rest in peace.
Setting aside the fact that the Exotico was the physical manifestation of at least 5 of the deadly sins, and the fact that it was run by that horrible, glutinous sloth, Filthy Rich.
Now, have you ever taken the time to speak to Filthy Rich? He's actually rather nice.
And the fact that it represented everything that was wrong with the Clapper's Greek Chamber of Commerce. I needed that.
Now, you're trying to say you wanted to get your hands all over Filthy Rich's massive throbbing pole.
Not in those exact words, but yes. You see, the bells are good, but to amplify the vibration of the bells to carry across the entire town,
you needed an enormous vibrator.
I needed the intense output of waves it provided to...
Your plan for the destruction and rebirth of a sinful town hinged on your acquisition of an enormous sex toy?
Well, yes. Kind of ironic, isn't it?
Oh, my God.
Never mind, I'll get it. What was the exact moment in your life that made you such an unhappy little man?
Oh, Hector, are you profiling me? Like an actual real detective?
No, I just want some backstory I can taunt you with later.
Well, since you're being so uncouth about it, I'll make this long and dull.
Ah, what the hell? Bold Bangs, what have I done?
Back when I was but a young lad,
we did all this back at the building.
Oh yes, right, we did. I'll skip ahead to college. As the town was quickly descending into the moral cesspit of Peccadillo, I had ascended to the top of my class at Clapper's Reek Polytechnic.
Ha! Top of his class? They give out diplomas like we give out parking tickets.
I graduated with honors, with a double major in hospitality and biochemistry. I was ready to challenge the world. Despite offers from all over the country, I made a beeline for the Clapper's Reek Tourism Board. I was going to do my best to turn this town around and make it a place to be proud of again. I had fresh ideas, new campaigns to bring in the tourists in droves, drive up the economy and the town's sense of self-worth.
Sponsor
if only they'd listened to me then.
The
town got worse. All tourism funding was poured into the ill-fated Clapper's Reek Charity Casino, and so began the avalanche effect. Crime, corruption, sin, debauchery. The town had slipped down a canyon so low that there was no way out. Except to keep digging, of course. Digging until you get so low you emerge out the bottom. And that's where Arsenal will punch through.
What exactly is in those badges?
Ready for another flashback?
Yep.
All right. Get on with it.
After the collapse of the tourist board, I hung up my hospitality coat in favor of my other college major, biochemistry. You see, I had a profound vision. Tell me, Hector, what is it that makes some people cheerful and others grumpy?
Parental approval, constant rejection, accessibility to pharmaceuticals, tosses like you. Oh my god.
Accessibility to pharmaceuticals? You're actually not that far off. It's a chemical imbalance in the brain. Take any behavioral disorder. Autism, Asperger's, OCD, ADHD. All can be modified by restoring a chemical balance to the brain through medication.
Right, so if it works for them, why not ourselves too?
Exactly. What if I could isolate the gene or synapse that causes impoliteness, sarcasm, general ill will?
You'd be putting me out of a job.
But isn't that a good thing?
Not to my wallet. I'd have to learn an actual skill, like timber joinery or Microsoft bleeding Excel.
After years of searching, I finally located the corner of the brain responsible for rudeness, disrespect, and deceit. I dubbed it the occipital lobe.
I would have gone for the ectoral cortex myself.
I hadn't met you yet. Once I'd found that, my goal was to synthesize a counteragent, Nicetol. Anyone exposed to Nicetol would have the occipital lobe physically shrink and become, in a word, nice. But what I discovered was quite the opposite. You see, it's much easier to enhance the qualities of the occipital lobe rather than suppress them. I've carried out illicit tests on animals and in some cases humans, and everything and everyone became angrier, meaner, less patient, and more violent.
In short, a complete arse.
You can have a blower.
Yes.
So, in attempting to create noise at all, you actually created
Arsenal. Buckets of it. Enough for every man, woman, and child in the town 10 times over.
Okay. Lure Gapoa.
So that's your plan? You're gonna turn everyone in town into arseholes?
Yes. An entire town of raving, vicious, amoral bastards.
How will you know it worked?
Because I'll be up here watching as the whole town boils over in a horrible bloody deathmatch. I've decided that this town is beyond saving, so I've decided to wipe the slate clean and start again.
So we expect to happen once the bells go off. Why don't you just move?
Why don't you just move to Newquay or something?
Why should I be the one who has to move? I'm the nice guy. You're kind of going against the grain a bit. This is my town, and you've all ruined it. So I'm going to ruin it back.
That's a bit immature.
You dare to call me immature?
Tosspot.
Oh. No, I'm gonna touch that.
So what do you expect to happen once the bells go off?
Right?
Chaos, disorder, mayhem, wanton destruction, and yes, murder. The town will devour itself in its own horrendous bastardness, the likes of which not even you could imagine.
I don't know. You should see my dreams.
And then, when the whole town lies dead, I'll emerge triumphant from my tower and build a happier, friendlier Clapper's Week from its ashes. Claptopia!
Where will you get the happy people from to repopulate it?
Canada!
Oh yeah, they're good people, except the French, of course.
Yeah, you're not kidding.
Your stories are the delusional, ludicrous gibberings of a raving half-wit.
Where have I heard that before?
I think I said something like that to you back at the building. It was such a well-phrased insult, I thought I'd use it again. I'll stall for time later. Stuff to do with it. Drop that whatever you've got in your hand and kick it across the floor to me.
What's this? You don't want me to do that.
Indeed I do.
You see, it's called a dead man's switch.
How appropriate.
It means that if I let go of it, the detonation sequence begins immediately. So if I die, or I'm knocked unconscious, or even just startled by a small bird, it's bye-bye Clapper's Reek. Still want me to kick it over?
Why don't you just wedge it between your arse cheeks nice and tight and waddle over to me?
Believe me, Hector, the only reason I haven't released Arsenal upon the town since you arrived... It's because I'd like to see you perish along with the rest of those imbeciles. Plus, it's scheduled for 10 o'clock and I'd like to be punctual.
Ay, 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 ay.
I've got this place surrounded.
Please, Hector, you're not that fat.
Why, Iota?
Come with me if you want to live.
Come with me if you want to live.
I was going to say the same to you. And then I thought about how little I wanted to spend the last days of Clapper's Reek with only you for company. So I just kept my mouth shut.
Can I please have that detonator?
Of course not.
I said please, that was really odd for me.
Oh wow, Hector, you've taught me that even you can learn from your mistakes and find politeness inside.
So can I have the detonator?
No.
Tossbag.
Okay.
Of all the tossers in the world, I had to run into you.
But Hector, you didn't just run into me. I engineered our meeting from the beginning.
Remind me to thank you properly later.
Better do it now. Doubt you'll be alive later to do it properly.
You seem busy. I won't keep you any longer.
Good one.
Ugh, empty. That old lush. Hold off on Armageddon just a few more minutes. I'm making popcorn downstairs.
Okay.
Right, there's got to be something around here I can use to unequivocally monkey up his detonator, what's it? Wonder where that clocksmith fella got off to. Probably airdropped him into downtown Tehran. They'll take anybody these days. I was hoping for the ultimate Molotov cocktail to bung up his device. Still, drunkards can't be choosers. Best to save it for something small.
Moonshine. The bumper? Okay.
Well, I'm sure I'll find a use for this. Strong little bugger.
okay. Just start to freeze, does it?
Sometimes a drip is all you need. Imagine what this could do for the chrome on me caravan. Now, let's see if there's anything useful in it.
Where's that bloody little Borko from the Preservation Society? I'll rip the Borko bloody smile from his Borko bloody Borko face. I'll... Oh, hello, it's you.
No, nothing useful in here.
Okay.
Nothing in here worth pilfering, unless we can dismantle an acoustic detonator with a flannel shirt.
I once took down an entire Icelandic conflict vessel with the brake pin in me wheelchair and half a toilet roll.
I don't suppose you have either of those on you, do you?
Nope. I used the last of it just now in the closet.
Definitely not worth searching further, then.
Oh, I'd best avoid it until cleaning lady gets here on Monday.
Prata med honom och se om vi lär oss något.
On your feet, soldier.
Eh? What? Corporal Flack? Sir! Sir, with all due respect, sir, I am standing at as full attention as I am capable, sir. Oh, wait, it's just you. Excuse me while I sit back down in disrespect.
There's a crazed terrorist up in your clock about to unleash hell upon the town.
Serves them bloody right, I say. Call me when the smoke clears. And get the door on your way out.
Quit your belly aching and get up those stairs on the double.
Stairs? Ha! Have you taken a look at me lately with your good eye? Last time I did bloody stairs, I was being pushed by Winston Churchill.
Forcefully and down, I reckon. If you don't do stairs, how'd you get up there to fix the clock?
Same way I always do. Oh.
Which is how exactly?
Oh, right. There's a dumb waiter behind the distillery.
Dumb waiter? Where does it go?
Opens out onto the roof. From there, I take the platform down and get in through the window to clock face.
Perfect. I can get onto the roof, and then when that smug son of a...
I don't mean to ruin your climax, but the dumb waiter only seats one, and that's me.
Uh-huh.
Why can't I go in the dumb waiter?
Because I rigged it in such a way that if anyone doesn't match my weight and size is allowed to get within 6 feet of the top, it plummets, killing whoever's inside.
Why would you do that?
Why else, bloody Borko spies?
Oh my god.
Look, you old codger, it's time to stand up for what you believe in.
Is that another crack at me wheelchair?
Of course not, I meant metaphorically stand up.
Then you can metaphorically piss up a flagpole, has it?
Come on, help me. Get your self-respect back.
Self-respect? Don't talk to me about self-respect. You're the one standing there in his underpants.
What the hell are you talking about? I'm fully dressed.
Eh? Oh, sorry, can't really see out of my left eye.
You help me take this guy down and I promise you a soldier's death.
Okay, I'm in.
I'm not leaving until you help me.
Piss off! Where's me blimmin' shotgun?
Good question. Where is your blimmin' shotgun?
Oh, right, there was a blockage in the distillery. Only thing I had long enough to waggle it out was me shotgun. Melted the shells and kablooey. Ears ringing like nab all over again. Or was it Gallipoli? Or are they all run together now? Barely hear you and your eye bleeding in front of me.
I need your help to unfix this clock.
You what? It's only been running for a bleeding day.
Okay.
Have you got any weapons in this class?
Okay, after losing the shotgun, all I got left are my wits.
So we're unarmed, then?
Well, pretty much.
Hang on. What was that noise in your head?
What's this? Yeah, just another one of me old war stories. You don't want to hear it, I don't expect.
No, no.
Are you kidding? I love your stories like dogs love licking themselves.
Oh, right then. It were night. surrounded on all sides, including above and below. Explosions coming from all directions. I was in the larder, trying to put together late supper for 800 injured soldiers. They called me Cookie. No time for imagination back then.
Is this gonna be a long one?
Then suddenly, bang! Bloody Borkos shot right through the hole. Non-perishables flying everywhere, nowhere to hide. No escape. Tin of chicken Vienna sausages lodged in the end. Still there, to this very day.
Well, I'm surprised they didn't make a movie of that.
Jerry Bruckheim is working on it as we speak.
Can I see the tin?
Ho ho ho, boyo. It's a gruesome sight for little eyes such as yours. I dare you to look upon this.
Well, who told you it was a tin of sausages?
Ha! Doctors told me not to worry too much about it. Why?
Because it ain't a tin of sausages.
Eh?
It's an unexploded bomb.
You what?
Probably told you not to worry because they figured you'd be dead in an hour.
That's why they put me in a ward by myself.
Can I see the bomb in your head again?
Oh, if you don't mind, can we keep calling it the tin of sausages?
Hey, your tin. Neat.
Okay.
You help me take this guy down and I promise you a soldier's death.
Okay, I'm in.
Sit tight.
I always do. I want my lower intestine in work.
Come on. Aye. Ooh!
Let's see that bomb in your head again. Right, now, hold still. This might pinch a bit.
Okay.
Well, I can see your brain. What happens when I do this? Well, see your leg just then?
That weren't my leg.
It's an unexploded bomb from Lord knows what war. Okay, nice and easy.
Yeah, I wouldn't be too worried about nice and easy. Fallen on me head more times than you've had hot ladies.
So, four times then.
Oh, really? No, I had you down for less than that. Well, regardless of your definition of hot, I wouldn't be too ginger with that thing. Around this long, should take one hell of a wallop to set that bugger off.
I'll keep that in mind.
Nah.
And to think I never got to taste this stuff.
Okej, nu ska vi se. Har jag något mer att säga nu då, kanske? Jo då, okay, I've got a plan.
Okay, I've got a plan. Right, you bring that bomb with you and take the stairs. I'll take the waiter to the roof. When you shout the code word, I'll distract him from outside. Once he's looking out the window for me, you place the bomb somewhere in the machinery where it's likely to receive a god-awful huge wallop. Then we wheel like wildfire out of there and watch the fireworks from a good distance away. They're just like Khrushchev's beach house all over again.
That's a pretty good plan. So all we need is a code word. I'll get him chatting and in mid-conversation I'll slip in a simple word like...
ball bags.
But avocado.
Avocado?
Worked fine at Khrushchev's beach house. Oh. No reason it won't work now.
Avocado?
Yep.
Seriously?
Yep.
Let's do this.
If we need to regroup, just knock twice on the distillery and I'll pop back down.
It's been an honour serving with you.
I'd like to say the same, but you're no Corporal Flack.
Okay. Oop, we'll say avocado. Vilken plan. Måste vi prata med kokon igen?
Oh, bro. That old coot actually came through.
Vart ska vi lägga bomben, tro? I vibratorn? han bara gå direkt på det eller vad?
In this light, your nose looks rather like an avocado. In this light, your hair looks rather like a fecal starfish.
Han är ju döv, gubben, vet du. Hur ska han höra när vi säger avokado?
All right, avocado face. You're finished in this town. On the contrary, I've barely begun in this town. Melon head.
Ska vi bara fortsätta då, kanske?
Your plan has more holes than a worm-eaten avocado, but still less than your shirt. You should see my underpants.
I have. How do you think I got you into that hospital gown?
You're dumber than a myopic Mexican heavy artillery engineer.
What does that mean?
Well, you see, being nearsighted, one might mistake a box of grenades for... forget it.
Sometimes I wonder about you.
Jag måste ner och byta kodord.
Excuse me, I have... Where is that deaf... Avocado? Bloody hell.
Det verkar inte som att avokado funkade särskilt bra.
Så. What the hell? I must have said avocado 50 bleeding times.
You said no such thing.
I did. I wasn't even subtle about it.
Oh, blast. Blimmin' ears still ringing like Bastille Day. I can only hear you when you stand right in front of me.
Can you hear anything up there?
I could hear him talking just fine. Must be your gravelly lower register voice. Terrorist sings like a blimmin' Vietnamese peasant girl, loud and clear.
Right, we need a new plane.
You pulling rank on me, young buck? I don't think so. The plan stays.
But you can't hear me.
Yeah, but I can hear him. All you need to do is get him to casually slip the word avocado into conversation.
Yep, the two of you there.
Dismissed.
Remember the avocado.
Avocado.
How could I possibly forget something so abysmally stupid?
Ben. Fortfarande nyfiken på vart bomben ska ligga sen.
So, that's what he needed the pawn shop demolished for. And it all comes together. That's a marvel of modern engineering, that is. I can't even work me digital cable.
Texten och ljudet i spelet är usynk. Ja, ibland... Ibland kommer det lite usynk, men om det är ofta så vet jag inte.
Old Clappy hasn't looked this shiny since the Blitz. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 5 bells. We're doomed.
Nej, osynkad. Är det spelljudet bara eller jag osynkad också?
Let's play a game. When I say "ah," you say "vacado."
What are you on about? Please, Hector, you're not making any sense.
Knock, knock. Who's there?
Spiele.
Avo.
Avo who?
Avocado. Ha! Ball bags, that didn't work. Okay, wait. This time you start.
I don't have time for your nonsensical games.
Så här kan vi inte ha det.
Listen, you can help settle a bit between me and a guy at work. Is guacamole made from pistachios?
What? Do I look like Wikipedia?
A little around the eyes. Before I die, I'd like to make one last request.
Oh, I suppose I owe you that much. What is it then?
I'd just like to hear you say one thing before you plunge the town into chaos and dismemberment, and that's...
Avocado.
Avocado.
That's the one thing in the world you want me to say?
Yes.
Out of all the words in the entire world?
Yes.
You want me to say?
Yes, bloody yes. Say it.
Avocado? Oh,
thank God.
What in the blue blazes is that?
Excuse me, your attention, please.
Sorry, distracted there for a moment. You were saying something about an avocado?
No, I wasn't.
Yes, you certainly were. You kept yelling avocado over and over. Avocado, 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 you kept saying. What the bloody avocados have anything to...
Damn.
Too much?
A bit, yeah.
Hell will erupt to the streets of Clapperswick. Civil disobedience will be uncontainable. Let the rehabilitation of Claptopia begin.
Här är en jättedildon.
Hector, our precious and expensive town clock, what have you done?
What have I done? I've just gone and saved the bleeding town from a bioterrorist plot, that's what I've done. There's your terrorist, Barnsley Noble, fine upstanding member of society, last officer of the tourism board, founder of the Clappers Reef Preservation Society and all-round arse barnacle.
I don't mean to be rude, but am I allowed a phone call?
Phone call?
Who's it got to make me mad?
Keep your tongue! Oh, Hector,
must have a spear
it's
letter.
Just a phone call.
Hello? Yes, it's
Barnsley. Sister har en större dildo från att fylla 15.
All done.
You see, Hector? No harm.
Attention, everybody.
To lighten the mood after the recent destruction of the clock tower, I've just been given the nod to spring one last surprise on you, and here it is.
Hey, that's enough milk, isn't it?
I personally would have preferred to deliver my own brand of chaos in a single serving sachet, but you forced my hand.
What have you done?
There's enough arsenal in there to gas the entire town five times over. Imagine the amount of carnage a badge that size will cause.
Yeah, one might even call it a badge of...
It's like it's been planned all along.
My God, is that kids on there? Make sure they take their shoes off.
Slut eller inte slut?
I have a sinking feeling that things could get rather nasty, what with a terrorist in our midst. So, if you require a soundbite, I'll be holed up in my office with the door locked. Good day. Like you've been sitting next to a murderer all morning. Yes, but look at him. If there were any way he could ever escape, do you think I would have brought him along? Why, trussed up like this, he looks almost cute. Anywho, Napu. Guess that leaves you, Lambert. I've got to deal with this bouncy badger of butchery, so I'm leaving this monster in your custody. This man is a danger to the community. Do not let him out of your sight.
Sure thing, boss.
Do not listen to anything this monster says.
Got it.
You're to tell him nothing personal, or he'll try to use it against you.
Okie doke.
I mean it. Don't even tell him what hand you wipe your ass with. Believe me, you do not want Barnsley Noble inside your head.
I was fine before. Now I'm crapping myself.
Okay.
Oh, terror has struck. As a result, Meeks is strangely absent.
What in the hell?
He shouldn't miss this.
Trapped. Okay.
I wonder if these are made of hemp. Nah, not enough raw materials left over to make hemp in this town. Good strong ropes.
I bet it feels nice to...
What are you?
Again? So what?
We'll probably get letters about this one. What the hell? There's a kid on there with shoes! Maltrade and DLC kill us all!
Oh, great idea. A giant balloon filled with toxic gas. Let's climb aboard. That was sarcasm, okay, by the way. Good strong ropes.
I can't combine.
Oh. Ingen aning om vad man ska göra, så vi får springa runt och leta lite.
Hey, the fat guy's back.
Enough.
It's not enough until I say it's enough. There, that's enough. Hey, Jimbo, see if you can find a casual way to get people to head for the exits. Nice work. Cut me tan at this little twerps. They'll go far. So, the wife turns to me last night and asks me if I smoke after sex. I said, I don't know, love. I've never looked.
Okay. Den här har vi inte gjort någonting med, så det kanske är här man ska vara. Gör han något nu då?
What's the matter? Just cold, man. Cold. I'm cold.
Could be Ebola.
Cut the crap. I know a flaky Charlie fit when I see one.
Whatever, man. I'll come clean. You've got me. Whatever. Just need one more fix, then I can go straight. The bugs are coming. Get them off of me. They're burrowing. Need a fix. Need a fix. Need a fix.
Oh, man. He's going sheen on me.
Well, those things together, not...
I'd have more fun tearing out my fingers with me teeth. Hey, pal, got any more of the white stuff?
I'm out, man. Out, out, out. Oh, God, everything's gone flat. Gotta sort me out. Need fix, man. Someone took it. Someone stole it.
Vi måste hitta hans knark.
Fix, 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 fix. Need.
Kids, don't do drugs.
Huh? Gissa på att vi är färdiga där. De här kommer vi inte in i.
Men and women, young and old, everyone loves.
Okej, det är stängt. Den var öppen innan.
I don't need to go, and even if I did, I wouldn't go in there.
Helium, kan vi inte bara fylla den med helium också?
Cripes, you'd think that'd be lighter full of helium and all.
Kan vi slanga helium, det kunde vi inte.
Nah, you're just being stupid.
En hash brownie. Skylt och så need fix på. Så vi går ge den till killen då kanske. Varför använder jag inte kartan? Dit. Det går ju fortare så här.
Here's your sign. Now remember our deal. I get some.
Then come. You.
You won't come if I'm here. Ha! It's been years since I spoke, smackhead. Funny how fast it all comes rushing back. Det måste
gå iväg. Antar jag, och sen kommer tillbaka.
Look, I'm gonna take the word of Captain White's stash here. I better stick around.
I de enorma kalsongerna.
Stretchy.
Ah, bakom. Där kommer han.
Jones, usual.
Hey, fix.
Oh man, you've gone too long. Mr. Fix will take care.
Salutations, Campadres.
Hey, who's the stiff?
Hickle.
Oh yeah, you heard him. I'm cool. Just a regular jive chicken, much like yourselves, looking to score.
Oh, I dunno, mate.
My friends call me Mr. Dope Fiend. Yeah, hoping to get smicked out on some nose candy real soon.
Gimme.
Yeah, give him. And if I may.
Well, he sounds legit. All right, man. Hey, man, what gives?
Sorry, my friends don't call me Mr. Dope Fiend. That was a bit of sneaky undercover jargon. I'm usually more commonly known as Detective Inspector Hector.
Oh, well, I should have guessed before the question earlier.
I'm on a very tight schedule. It's not normally like me, but if you give me the drugs, I'll let you off with a warning.
Works for me. Pretty much standard procedure in this town, yeah.
Right, okay. Hey. Ciao, boys.
Ett paket knark. Så vi gör med den då. Addictive substance. Ska han ha något sånt, kanske?
Yeah. Consider today the start of his 12-step rehab program. This makes me practically his mentor.
Tillbaka hit. Vi måste ju fortfarande göra något med den här killen. Han är knark. Hur dör knark?
What are you?
The terrorist scum. Ungarna knarkar ju. De kanske vill ha knark.
All those things together, not bloody like.
Då går vi hit bort då. Jag måste ju testa allting. Hon vill ha knark kanske.
Here you go, darling. Put this on your buns.
Det är typ en hash brownie kanske.
And that is not an invitation for an act of gross public indecency, which would make me feel even more nauseous than your cooking.
Oh, what is it?
Powdered sugar?
But most of my cakes are 99% sugar anyway.
Oh, but is it powdered?
Well, hell, why not? Everybody likes sugar, right? Your keeper can't get enough of it. Why, when he gets his hands on a bowl, he just keeps eating it and eating it till it's gone.
Go on, a light dusting over the top of everything.
Knark på alla kakorna.
Hey, you guys smell that? Wow, that bacon reminds me of dear old poo. Give me a slice of whatever you're selling.
Hög som ett hus.
Wow, this cake is stupefyingly horrible, but I must stand more.
What the hell?
Gordon Ramsay's wig, this is damagingly addictive.
Sweet lord, it's like having my tongue run over a cheese grater by Nigella before she got fat.
Hey, this one had a file in it. I lost 3 cheese, which means there's now more room in my mouth.
Ut med tänderna som har fått in mer kakor i munnen. Okej, vi har en fil.
File saved.
Wait, mister, I owe you a cake.
Keep it, darling. I got what I came for. Go ahead and sell mine on to one of these mugs, but do Kiefer a favour and start up an ISA. For I have a sneaking suspicion that he and I will be meeting in a professional capacity in the not-too-distant future.
Okej, nu kan vi titta på det här då.
Hey, can I have a go? Hey, you the guy that improved that girl's cakes?
Yeah.
Then no, you can't. Look, he's like a little tiny stationery salesman with targets on.
Okay.
What are you? A cop.
What, those things?
Okay.
Nah, you're just
being... Varför kan jag inte...
Hey, come on, let me try. Don't you have a town to save? Yeah, better get back to it. He looks just like Barry. Where's that gun?
Huh.
Hello, hello. Oi, oi, little guy. Where's your smile?
Fila över repen? Kan det vara något?
Twat!
You're dead before
six. Dead before six.
Kom igen nu, kom igen nu. Ta det lugnt. Nej, kan inte gå dit. Varför kan jag inte gå dit? Vilka dumheter. Spelet är lite buggigt.
Happy belated okay. Birthday.
Do vicious murderers celebrate
birthdays? Okay. Släppte loss en mördare i stan.
Playing musical chairs and eating Rice Krispie buns. Actually, scratch that. I just did.
Good. Three cheers for health and safety.
I just hope I don't get backsprain from carrying it around in my pocket.
För min idé är att man fyller den med helium och skickar upp den i luften bara. Du går där åt, tack. Okej, okay, nice. Då har vi helium.
Right, let's go save the town while at the same time make all the children cry. It's like getting cream and marshmallows.
Ja, tillbaka dit igen då kanske. Varför inte folk är idioter och behöver dö? Sant.
I think I saw an air valve around the other side.
Pia noga. Ja, jag ser in.
Gotta be quick about it.
Bro, magic's gonna fly. Exactly. Now to do something about these ropes.
Det mördar vad du handvägen handlar väl om bast kanske. Vi börjar längst bort och så jobbar vi oss bakåt igen då. Är det något i toaletten?
I don't need to go. And you even if I did, I wouldn't go in there.
Där det här va? Kan vi prata med dig nu?
Hey, can I have a go? Hey, you the guy that improved that girl's cakes?
Yeah.
Then no, you can't.
Know what would make this even better? A tiny call center.
Det ser ut som det brukar göra.
Never.
Heller den här gången. Här var det tomt.
I distrust any piece of machinery that has more than 6 fluorescent colours on it. A moron can run this ride. In fact, I think one already does. I'll come.
You're not...
The regurgitator, just this side of death. Our machine that induces dry retching can be called fun, I'll never know.
You're not here. Bilen är ju borta, ja.
Your life and the lives of all these people are in grave danger. I think.
Sucha, skikta man när laddar.
Du, man kanske kan åka till klockdomet. Kanske du vet. Kort, nu har vi den jättestora dildon.
Not exactly a pocket rocket, is it? All that work for nothing. Can't drive it. Lost the keys. Plus, it's quite obviously totally banjaxed. That one rings way down deep. Another town landmark in tatters. That makes a trifecta for me this week.
Nej. Nej, tillbaka igen. Jag kanske vill ha tillbaka den.
What are you? Any? I can't combine those things. Well, those things to... Nah, you just... Nah.
We can approve it all.
What are you?
So, Lambert har något att säga, kanske? Han brukar ge lite små tips ibland.
Badger's about ready for takeoff. How do I snip a set of giant ropes?
By roping a set of giant snips, of course.
DJ had a Yoda.
Don't let me...
Tillbaka dit. Där är traktorn.
Coming up soon, I will phone a takeaway and order a large number of pizzas to a fake address under the name My Crotch. It's gonna be hilarious, even funnier than when I did it yesterday, because today I will be talking
to you with an accent.
I'm from the Giant Ceremonial Items Commission of the Mayor's Office. Ah, suppose you'll be wanting these scissors back. Indeedy do.
Well, just try and take them then.
Okay.
You made it sound like you were gonna make a bigger deal of it.
Nonsense. Always happy to help. Oh, and sir, if I may.
Had to squeeze that last one in, did ya?
Wrong. Had to squeeze that last one out.
Jag tror inte det är så mycket kvar i spelet, så... Nej.
I can't combine those things.
Ja, titta. Hoppade barnen av?
Well, Barnsley, some things don't.
Hector!
Boss Banks.
So long, and thanks for all the help.
That tosser's not getting away. I am bringing him down.
Och hur ska det gå till då? Öltältet är förstört.
Where'd bloody Lambert run off to? I could use a hint.
Yeah, not.
Where'd bloody... That's back to the end.
Behöver något skjuta med, det borde de ju ha på... Här borta? Ja, titta, bössan.
Sir, where before I was merely satisfying my curiosity, I now must insist that you hand over the rifle.
What for?
See that bouncy badger floating away? I'm gonna shoot it down and kill the man on board. Be my guest. Hey, Barnsley, we don't need no stinking badgers. What the hell? Did you know this was water? Ball bags. Wasting my one-liner. Now I'm gonna need a new one for later.
Eh?
It's a blimmin' squirt gun for blimmin' sake. It's a blimmin' squirt gun. Well, those things...
Huh.
Now you're... I'm sure they'll be raving about those cakes for hours. Husband never made parole. Show him that you love him with a chocolate roll. Look, he's like a little tiny stationery salesman with targets on.
Vad fan ska jag göra då?
Glad someone official was in there to restore some kind of order. Well, officials a bit of a stretch.
Huh.
Nah. What a fair kind of ends with...
Yeah.
Oh, come.
Jag dyker upp där när jag är klar. Jag vill spela till slutet. Men tack för att du dök förbi Scarecrow, så ses vi senare.
Now you just...
And all this time I must have been enjoying the bitter kind.
I have a confession to make. I knocked down your pawn shop.
You did?
Yep.
I really wish you hadn't told me that.
Sorry.
There goes my plausible deniability. Anyone from Middle Army?
Eh?
Ciao. Later.
Vi här igen. Här har vi inte gjort så mycket.
Nä.
Kan vi inte bara sätta den där så flinga upp den?
What are you?
Oh. Du stretchy.
The disappointment.
Skjuta jättedildon med den.
Stretchy.
Vi måste hitta någon mer först i så fall.
Well, nice.
Look at behind.
Never trust a bush in this town. I'd be safer throwing myself. The more I could run.
Kanske ta en hint. Här har han hans bruttskämt.
It's like he wanted.
Still we didn't. Ta ett varv till. Du har inget nytt att säga, va?
Good day, handsome.
Oil.
Shorty.
Well.
Ooh, that reminds me.
Not a little.
Shorty poaches.
Well.
Much as I'd like to smack that guy in the gym jowls, I've got stuff. See any unsavory characters about? Besides me.
Face paint.
I can't believe that worked.
Lycka till Patrik, så ses vi sen.
We'll probably.
Han med maten i början har inte gjort något med mig någonsin, tror jag. Har jag?
What are you?
Jag tar en titt här igen. Okay. The badge of Lucy Rain, who's on board. Shooting down with what? Dig up something that looks rather like a projectile. Yup, then har vi. You need something with a very high tensile strength, barbarics, and a count. Det har vi. Okej, okay, nu ska vi inte läsa mer, nu ska vi gå tillbaka dit. Kanske bara måste... Så här. Var det så enkelt?
All right, Barnsley. Prepare to receive the arse. What in the only living toss?
That's right, Hector. I've got your partner. Do you save the innocent or punish the guilty? What do you do, Hector? Hector, I may be your partner and we've been through so much together, but you can't let him escape. Shoot!
That's me fine.
Nice knowing your
land, but... Kommer jättedildon! Puff! Oh my god!
Sweet holy mother of mayhem, isn't this thing over yet? Wait a minute. You just ingested 10,000 doses of arsenal. So why are you not a horrific, ravenous, marauding, mutant bastard from Crazy Town?
Simple. I swallowed the antidote. Your partner, on the other hand... Sadly for your partner, I only ever made one dose of the antidote, and it's currently residing right here.
Not for long.
Nice. Nu ska vi tratta grejer.
Right, we're not taking any chances this time. Your festival is deserted, your plans are ruined, and the only reason you aren't dead yet is because you're the only man who can save my partner. Now, where can I get more antidote?
You can't. The only cure you'll ever find is currently residing in my tummy.
Gents, keep your eyes on this turd bucket until I can find a way to deal with Lambert. You got that?
Close enough. Och hälla ner i käften på honom. Det här kan vi ta, tror jag.
There's a bit of that glute left in the bottom.
Okay, nice, also to work out.
I don't know.
So we can combine them two. So it's from the smart that we want.
All right, Barnsley. You won't cough up the antidote, then I'm coming in after it.
You animal! What was that horrible stuff?
You know, I've been trying to work that out myself all day.
Food! Imagine
food wording kit.
Happy food!
What, like a steak and kidney milkshake?
Celery!
Goose liver roly-poly?
Muesli!
Pork scratchings on a bed of Marmite rocket?
Quinoa! Whew.
That did it. You're not getting my antidote that easily.
His stomach's stronger than that, Clocksmith. Maybe I'll need to take it to the next level.
Yeah. The next level. Dasset är rätt jävla vidrigt. Kanske vi kan göra något med det. Du är fortfarande här och lurkar. Skitbra. Har du några tips? Hur går det med, är du färdig med Oldboy eller? Inte så pratglad och du är sjuk och elend. Då ska jag inte prata så mycket, ser du. Hade öltältet varit helt hade vi ju kunnat trycka igenom det. Oh shit, det var han.
The day Lambert became a bigger bastard than me, the boys back at the station will never let me live it down. Don't.
Spel 70.
Well, oh my that God. Was effective. Kind of exciting for me to be battling some outer demons for a change. Avocado. Don't. Those things together, not bloody. You don't think Lambert? Nah, she probably remembered to take the baby with her.
How am I giving to you? Can we set on me?
Nah, you just beat. Nah. Filthy rich lives to bolt another day. Filthy.
Oh, can we set on me then? Ha!
I wonder if it does what it says on the tin.
Nu jävlar.
Alright, Barnsley. You won't cough up the antidote. Ever wonder what a puppy in a dryer feels like? You know, given time, I could probably forgive you for what you did to my partner, to the townspeople, to the 37 cops you shot, to Filthy Rich, to that badger, and I'm sure countless other woodland creatures. But dressing me in an hospital gown and making me look a dip in public, that is not on.
You really think of no one but yourself, do you?
Sorry, did you say something? I couldn't hear you over the sound of retching. Well, there he goes.
Okay.
That's it. Get it all out.
You're beautiful.
No time to look for sterilized gloves or forceps or any of that. Just gonna have to go for it. Well, at least I don't have to eat it.
I don't have none on them now.
How irresponsible of me not to stop the machine.
Oh my God.
He's chewing up a pneumatic drill like it's bright and raw, and I'm just gonna saw her up and place a tablet on his tongue. Bollocks to that. I'd offer it. Loaded. Now, let's finish this thing. I could use a nap.
Oi, Lambert! Open wide, you mutating son of a.
That'll work.
Wow, what a migraine. I don't remember much of what happened.
All you need to know is it's over now. And if it wasn't for me, you'd be dead. So you owe me big time.
Well, thanks, boss.
That, and you ate four people.
Me?
Release me!
Lugnt, virus!
Someone!
Please!
Let's get this moron brought back down to justice.
Release me!
As you wish. Whoa! Well, that's one more head case off the streets. Plenty more running round loose out there, that's guaranteed. They don't call this place the crime capital of Britain for nothing. I was the unwitting accomplice to his twisted plans, and in the end, he met his horrible fate by my hands. Does that make me just as bad as him? If it does, Lambert, you'd better cover that up in your report, which is due on my desk tomorrow.
Oh, I was hoping to take the night off.
Sorry, Lambert. Police work never ends. Not till the admin's done. Now, I've got something for you.
For me? Really?
It's the first place ribbon from the Strictly Come Girling contest. After you ingested that toxin, I've never seen such a hideous, mutated freak of nature as you, Lambert.
You deserve it.
Oh, thanks. I won something. I'm truly chuffed, Hector.
Come on. If we hurry, we can catch the off-license before it shuts. I'll let you buy me a crate of beer as a little thank you for saving your ugly ass.
Yes, sis. Okej, rättvisa. Wow, who cares? Oj, 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 helt klart ett bra spel. Utan tvekan. Tack för GG. Se här. Vilket var det andra spelet vi fick med att köpa? Men det är nog svaret jag på den, ja. Kom bara inte ihåg vilket andra var. Tack för GG ett spinmaus. Alan Wake, ja. Då har jag gillat båda spelen. Herregud. Ska jag också hoppa över till Melee så vi slänger den host åt det hållet. Inside också. Fanns ju knappt att få tag på, men jag letade upp ett gammalt lager på Ginza. Ja, det är sant. Jag har ju faktiskt till och med Alan Wake stående i hyllan här fortfarande. Vi kan ju göra en raid kanske. Det har jag inte gjort. Skriver man bara så här tror jag. Så jag tackar så mycket för alla som var här. Och ja, det har varit, nu har vi avslutat två spel idag. Så häng gärna med på raiden, så ses vi hos Melio om en liten stund. Så får ni ha det tokbra. Ses vi kanske imorgon för mer stream. Det vet jag inte förrän imorgon. Gott polisarbete vet du fan, men någonting blir gjort i alla fall. Så vi tackar så mycket.